Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we're going to talk about an interesting topic, phantom atoms. This has relevance in stereochemistry. And you encounter phantom atoms when you have pi bonds. And you have to expand these pi bonds and create artificial atoms as placeholders so we can apply the Cahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. So we have a molecule on the screen. Here is a stereocenter. It's attached to four, carbons attached to four different groups, and we have to assign priorities. If we do, oxygen is going to be one, hydrogen is conveniently drawn in the back, it's going to be four, and then we have these two carbons. So this carbon, we'd say, well, that carbon is attached to another carbon right there, and it's attached to two hydrogens. Okay, that's clear enough. How about this carbon? This carbon is attached to another carbon, the bottom of the alkene, and it's attached to a hydrogen, but what do we do for its third bond? Well, this is where phantom atoms come into play. So let's expand this out with phantom atoms. And my pen is going to skip, of course. Okay, so here's our molecule. And I'm going to draw in placeholders. So this carbon, we're going to say this carbon has a bond to a phantom carbon, and people typically put those in parentheses. What we've done is we've broken the pi bond. Let's take this pi bond. This carbon, if we break the pi bond, we have to account for the fact that it's also attached to a carbon. So now when we do our comparison, we can say, okay, this carbon, when we assign priorities, that's attached to a carbon, a hydrogen, and a carbon, and that carbon hiding in there is attached to a real carbon, the one I have the cursor over. It's attached to a phantom carbon. And then there's a hydrogen there as well. So now, when we compare these carbons are going to have to face off and see who has priority two, who has priority three. They both first play a carbon. That's a tie. The second atom they can show, the left-hand carbon has a hydrogen, this one has a phantom carbon. That phantom carbon counts as a real carbon. So this carbon on the right, therefore, is the higher priority. So we'd say the oxygen's four, the oxygen is one, the hydrogen is four, this carbon on the right is two, that one's three, so this would be one, two, three, that's clockwise. This stereocenter would have the R configuration. So we use phantom atoms as temporary placeholders so we can apply Cahn-Ingold-Prelog rules.